Welcome back to the Bookbinding e-course. We are now at Lesson 3. Today, we'll be learning how to create a strong and durable book spine for your book so that your book can last longer. Before we start creating your spine, firstly we need to create a setup to hold your book together. In this course, we are using a clamp setup that includes the use of two pieces of thick wood clamped together using two clamps. Alternatively, you can use two thick and heavy books to hold your book project in place during the subsequent processes. Note that the weight should restrict movement of the book when we are creating the spine later on. You can refer to your PDF guide for a visual representation of the clamp setup. Once you have your book set up, it's time to start creating your spine. The first part of creating your spine involves strengthening it. The linen tape alone is not enough, so we'll be adding 3 more layers to the spine. We will be using paper for the first 2 layers and a recycled cloth for the last layer. So let's get started. Prepare your glue. Use your sponge brush to apply a thick and even layer of glue along your book spine. Measure and cut out 4 pieces of recycled paper using the spine regions that are not covered by the linen tape. Paste these small pieces of paper onto these regions. And now you are done with the first layer of your book spine. For the second layer, we will also be using paper. This time, the paper will cover the entire spine. So measure and cut out the paper. Use your sponge brush to spread an even layer of glue along your book spine and paste the strip of paper onto your book spine. With that, your second layer of book spine is done. Again, use your sponge brush to spread an even layer of glue on your book spine. Next, prepare a recycled strip of cloth that is slightly bigger than your book spine. Paste the strip of cloth onto your book spine. Ensure that the cloth is stuck on properly. You can use your fingers to press out any air bubbles or spaces that may be formed during the previous steps. Use the scissors here to hit the spine to get rid of the air spaces. Also make sure that the excess glue comes out onto the cloth. And now we are done with your book spine. Leave your book spine to dry for at least an hour before continuing with the next part, where we will be completing your book spine. Once the glue on your book spine has dried, trim off the excess cloth and linen tape along the book spine. Do leave some of the cloth and linen tape hanging over the length of the book spine as you trim off the excess. Stick the excess cloth and linen tape down onto the book. Do this using glue. Once you're done, wrap your book with a plastic bag or a piece of paper to prevent glue from getting on your blocks of wood or your books. Then, clamp the book or place it under 2 heavy books and let the glue dry for at least an hour. Again, store your book in a safe place and stay tuned for lesson 4 that's coming tomorrow. we will be learning how to create a book headband as well as start to create your book cover tomorrow. See you then!